For you today, hallelujah, those who came by ways of invitation, members, those followers, God bless you, we welcome you today. But there is a word in the house, it's for the body of Christ at large. How many of you all know what it is to go through difficult time in life? Just wanted to give up on God. How many of you all just know what it is to just want to quit, and you just don't want to carry on, even existing? I came with a word to just strengthen you today. The Lord told me to speak on fainting by the wayside. We got some wayside fainters.
Yes.
And I believe that we all have been there one time or the other. Mm-hmm. Where we want to just stop. But God has given us a word today to pour into your spirit. The book of Matthew 15:32. Hallelujah, I'm going to look at verse 22. And Jesus called his disciples to him and said, I feel compassion for the people because they have reminded me.
Yes.
They have remained with me for 3 days and have nothing to eat. And they don't want to even, you know, we don't want to send them away hungry. If we do, they will faint on the wayside. From the natural means, Jesus saw the And he had such great compassion for the multitude, you know, the story that followed him. And he, as he ministered from the Sea of Galilee, many came. And I believe at that particular time that many came knowing that the journey was long. And I believe that some of them came with little bags of food. And for him to came across the land with the fish and the bread, I believe that some persons had their bag packed. Some was packed. I believe some was ready for the journey. And then the Bible assured us that because of the long waiting and the time of impartation spiritually, the people then run dry. They needed some natural food. And Jesus didn't want to leave them just that way and send them back in the way towards their home and not knowing that they might faint because of a lack of food, substance on the inside. Many are in the body of Christ similar to one that desire or need food from the natural to survive. There are some of us out here starving from spiritual impartation. God brought me this, I brought me the scripture. He said, bring it in this likened daughter, make them to know that they're fighting up the natural body, but their spirit are dying. We can eat and we eat on time, and they must eat on time. We don't miss our timing of eating. Some must eat more than 2 times a day. And let me just make sure that our natural body is healthy and we take all our nutritions and all of our vitamins and we build up this natural body, which is good. But your spirit man are dying. Your spirit man are fainting by the wayside. I came with a word today. God said to tell the body of Christ, you, yes, you. For you to fail on the wayside, somehow you got to somehow be unveiled to the truth. And you just fainted. Some people just giving up on life on a whole. Some have not come into the light yet. So what matter you know if you don't come into the light and you're not saved? You just on a downward road to hell. But I'm speaking to the body of Christ. And even if someone are deciding to just give up on life from the realm of the natural, we encourage you that Jesus is the way, the truth, and the light. But this word is for the church. But those who've been running for a long time, been doing some work for the Lord, been pouring out daily, but somehow they are running dry. The Lord said in this hour, the Bible showed us how Jesus had compassion. Someone said compassion. You better know in this hour his compassion towards us is new every morning. You better know in this hour he knows exactly where you are. He knows your frailness. He knows how weak you are. He knows what you already opened up your doors to. He knows who you are in and out. We might look at the outward appearance, but God searches the heart. He knows where you are in the realm of the spirit as well as the natural. Hallelujah. Jesus found a place just to minister. My God, the power of God to many. But they were still lacking at the point after they poured out spiritually, they needed food. What are lacking in your life today besides impartation? What are you feeling on the wayside because of? What is distracting you in this hour?
Amen.
I came with a word to strengthen you today.
Yes.
The danger of the multitude at this time, and they run out of food. They run out of food in the wrong place. The wilderness. Some of us in the wilderness.
The wilderness.
Some of you all are dry. And you all are weary and fainty.